Hello everybody and welcome to another video tutorial. Today we'll be updating the firmware under Ender 3 V2 with either the official release or with the community version. Full disclaimer, I'm in no way responsible if any damages may occur, so do this at your own risk. So there's a couple of reasons why you might want to update your machine's firmware, but the main one is to fix any issues in operation, which can often include safety upgrades. Some community versions include added functionality as well as a more up-to-date version of Marlin. The process will be identical to either version of the firmware, as long as you understand some of the basics. First off, there's two portions of the machines which typically need to be updated separately. The first is the motherboard, which is normally quite simple to update, and the second is the screen, which often requires some form of disassembly. I should point out that sometimes this process isn't straightforward on certain machines, therefore you'll always want to do some research before undertaking this task. There's two different types of motherboards for this machine, and we'll need to know which version ours is prior to uploading the firmware. To find this out, we'll open up the base of the machine and read the labeling that's on the motherboard. In my case, it was the 4.2.2, so that'll be the version I will be downloading. In my testing, I did update the machine with a larger 32GB card. However, if you run into issues, you may wish to switch to an 8GB card instead. Once you've formatted the card to a FAT32, you'll download the file from either the Corrali website or the GitHub page. I'm going to include a direct link for both options in the description below. In my case, I chose to use the community version since it includes several additional features which include but aren't limited to the following: a manual leveling menu, Z offset menu, preheat menu, change filament, support for the M600 command, manual mesh leveling, and an advanced menu which may be updated in the future. First, we'll download the .bin file that's going to be used to update the motherboard, and that'll be one of these files here. The files all follow a simple naming convention to make it easier to tell which option is the most suitable version for your machine. The first part of the name refers to the machine, which in this case is the Ender 3 V2. The second portion is the leveling method, followed by the probing layout and motherboard version. If you're looking to use the stock version, then you'll want to choose the default version. In my case, I wanted to install the default version since I would be updating to a BL Touch at a later date. Now that we have the motherboard firmware downloaded, we can now download the folder to update the screen. For this, you'll scroll down and download the source code for this machine. Once you've downloaded this folder, you'll unzip it and go to Marlin plus Display plus Firmware Sets, where you'll choose the version that you want to use. In my case, I chose the Dwin Set Gotcha version for this update. If you're updating with the Corrali versions, then all the necessary files will be within the zip folder that you download. You'll copy the .bin file to your SD card once it's been formatted to FAT32. Turning off your 3D printer, you'll insert the SD card into the card reader, then power back on the machine. It will take a while longer to boot up, but once it's finished loading the screen, the update should be complete. With the main motherboard updated, it's now time to update the screen as well. In this case, updating the screen is optional, but I highly recommend doing it since it solves the contrast issues which were present in the original version. Make sure to reformat the card again before copying your Dwin Set Gotcha files to your SD card. You'll need to rename the folder so that you're left with just a Dwin Set as a name. After turning off the printer, we'll lift the screen out of its stand and turn it over to unplug the cable. Once that's completed, we can then unscrew the cover and use a prying tool to remove the panel. You'll notice an SD card reader, which is where we're going to be inserting the SD card into. Simply turn on the machine to start the updating process. In this case, the screen will change to an orange color once it's finished updating. Simply close everything back up and put everything together, and you should be ready to go. One of the nice features in this update is the ability to change the interface colors to whichever ones you want. As you can see, I've begun playing around with these and many other settings to get the best results for this machine. I've started creating downloadable support files and mods for the machines I've reviewed, so if you're looking for some additional information, I would suggest you follow the link in the description below. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys again soon. Thank you and take care.